Hey, this is Frank, and I'm here today as part three of a multi-part series in which we are in the process of upgrading my portable power pack from 2.2 kilowatts to over 4 kilowatts, I hope. The DIY Engineer channel. On this channel, we do everything DIY. Everything from batteries, which is what we're doing now, to construction projects, concrete countertops, framing, remodeling, even car work. So we'll do a whole gamut of fun things DIY. My goal is to post every Tuesday. So that's my goal and my commitment to you is to post on Tuesdays. If this channel is helpful to you or if you find it interesting, please subscribe below. And please leave any comments you might have that I might be able to assist you with. Today we're going to be going into a couple different things. We're going to follow up again on the spreadsheet I left with you last time that you can see how calculations are done. We're going to do a really quick calculation and make sure we're on track for putting together the portable power pack upgrade. Then we're going to actually take some of the information that I've already gathered in tearing apart all my cells and organizing them. And we're gonna take and run those through Repacker to create the small cell packs that will go into each of the three big batteries that we're gonna put together. And with that, let's go to the computer.
So here we are in the computer. We wanna look at the cells that I'm gonna be using for building out this rebuild of my portable power pack. In here is my cell harvest spreadsheet, my master spreadsheet, which has all of the cells that I've harvested. I'm right now upwards of just under 2,200 cells that I've harvested in total. The greater majority of that is going to go towards my power wall, which I have currently about 1,400 cells that will be used for my power wall. In here, what you can see is just a bunch of cells. What I did is, if you remember, I tore apart my portable power pack. The previous cell blocks or the batteries, tore them all down, and now I've taken and I've organized them all in numeric order. So what's the key here is the cell IDs over here on the right in the blue, not the green, but those are the IDs for each of the cells. So every cell has its own unique ID. And what I'm interested in from this spreadsheet, once I've tore those packs apart, I put them into these packs here in numeric order so that I know which cells I'm going to be using. And so to get that total, what I had to do was come over here into my calculator and I put in a 12 volts for my desired voltage because that's what my inverter runs for my portable power pack. And each of the cell groupings is going to be 40 cells. Well, that gives me a grand total of 480 cells that I need. So out of my reference pack here, out of all of these cells, I needed to come up with 480. And I did just that. I was able to put together 480 cells. And this is the cell listing here. So you can see starting this column A is all of the cell IDs all the way down through. And then in this right-hand column here under N is the milliamp hours for each of those cells. It's all I'm interested in. I do have all the other demographic information here, but I'm only interested in the cell ID and it's compatible, or the size, the milliamp hours for each of those cells. So going from here, what I needed to do was, I'm going to go back up to the top here, and I'm going to grab all 480. So I have 480 cells in here. I'm going to grab all 480 of these, and so we'll just copy those over. And what I need to do is bring those into a text editor so I can make them common to limited. So let me show you why. This is Repacker. So if you want to do these cell packs, they're designed for, you know, taking recycled cells and building, you know, e-bike, power wall, etc. Just stuff for 18650 projects. And it's repacker.com. There's another one that you can use as well if that one isn't available at DIY. Powerwalls.com. They have a cell They have a pack builder as well. It's the same script. So you can go to either one, and they're both very helpful. Gives you the same information. I've just used Repacker longer than this site's, the DIY Powerwalls has been around. They came online quite a while after Repacker was already there. So anyway, so what I needed to do is in there, it needs it to be comma separated for each cell. And currently in my list, they're not. They're all vertical and they're stacked on top of each other. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use, let me delete that. I'm going to use Text Wrangler. So if you know of a better text editor for a Mac, I'd like to know. I don't love Text Wrangler, but it's what I got. So anyways, go ahead and paste those in here, and you'll see they're all just vertical, and I need to make them comma delimited. Well, the quickest way to do that is just to do a find. Search for any slash n, which is new line, and I want to replace it with a comma. And if I go replace all, it builds out my my full line of string. So let's go to the beginning of this, Control Shift to the end, or Command Shift to the end, and we're going to copy it. So now I have everything comma delimited, and those are all of my milliamp hours for my cells. Back into Chrome and over here to Repacker. I'm going to add those cells in comma delimited. So now I have 480 cells in here. Just really threw them all in, and Repacker gave me some errors up here saying I needed to add series, the number of series or cells in series, then the number in parallel. And I'll just show you a couple times. I'll actually do this a couple times. I'm going to leave the 480 cells in here because it'll take them when we feed this either way. So going back over here to the calculator, we had 40 in parallel. So if I come back to Repacker and I go down to parallel, I put in 40, it recognizes it, and one of the error messages goes away. And if I look over here, I need 4 in series. And so if I go and I select 4 in series, even though I have 480 cells in here, it still likes it. And I can say, all right, generate the packs. And it'll go and it'll build out 4 packs out of the cells above. So what I'm looking at here is my 4 separate packs. This is going to create, or this could create, one battery. So I have 40 in parallel in each of these series packs, and or in serial. So anyways, this is kind of neat because it shows a breakdown of what the capacity is amongst these cells. And it looks to me like it took my top rated cells and it dumped out all the lower end ones. So it even had some intelligence to it so it could get rid of ones that out of that 480 cells, it stripped out all the ones that were like 1800 milliamps and only took the high ones like this 2712 and 2519. My average capacity for these packs, we're looking at 120 amp hours. So that's actually quite a bit for each of these different packs. And you'll notice that there's just a little bit of divergence here. This has a negative one. These here are zeros. So this is 0, 0, and 0, meaning that the capacity for each of those is the same, which is nice. Now, why do this? I mean, really, why do this? Well, what it comes down to is if your battery cells, if your battery pack, when you have these cell packs, if they're consistent on the volume or the amps or amp hours that are in each one of those, you're going to get a consistent drain. You're going to have a battery that's more consistent than just guessing. It's not guesswork. We're actually using logic to make them physically the same size. So this is very, very handy. All right. Once I had that information, down here, there's a section where you can go and copy all that data into a spreadsheet. And we'll do that after I get the other 40 cells. All right, so back up here, we need not just 4 of these packs, because what it comes down to is I'm building out, so what you have is you have 40 in parallel, and so that will be one pack. And then we're going to take 3 of those packs, or 4 of those packs, to create the battery. And then we're going to take three batteries in parallel to give us our total of what we're going to have, whatever that might work out to be. So instead of it being four, I actually need it to be 12, because if you have four times three, it's going to give you 12. And that's what we need to figure out. We need 12 packs in series. So I'm going to go back, and they're not going to be in series total. They're only going to be four, but I'm going to have three separate batteries, just to be sure we're clear on that, so it's not too confusing. And hopefully I'll show some pictures that'll help simplify that. Back over here in Repacker, instead of four, I'm going to put in 12. And no errors. So Repacker recognizes that I'm still using this 180 cells up here. 180? Is that what it is? That was 160. Nope, it's 180. That's a lot of cells. I'm telling you, that's a lot of cells. All right, so generate a pack. And then so it's going to use the cells, the milliamp hours that are up there. It's going to create four in series and 40 in parallel. So now if I look down through here, the pack sizes are a little smaller, but you'll notice that there's just a little bit of divergence. It's not a lot. Minus one, some of these are zero. So this is actually pretty good. And there's 12 separate packs now that we can utilize. So this separate data down here is the data that we can copy into a Google spreadsheet or Excel or wherever. And what I'm going to do is just use my keyboard here and highlight these. I could probably use a Command A as well. And copy. So once those are copied, I'm go back over here to my master sheet. And I have this section here. I created a new tab and I called it new cell packs. And just selecting cell A1, and I paste those in, and there is all my milliamp hours for my 12 separate cell packs. So that'll work out really well. We'll be able to have that capacity or have the cells all lined out. Now, how do I go about finding these to build out? So this here would be, we can call this, you know, cell pack A, and its total capacity, and I need to go and find each of these cells. Well, this isn't actually very difficult because of the way I organize my cells. So if I go in here and I select one, say this one for 2166. Okay, if I copy this here and then I come back over to my cells, these here are my identifiers for each cell, and these are the milliamp hours, and I'm looking for a milliamp hour. So if I go find that 2166, right there, its cell ID is 68. So I can go right into these packs, start going in numeric order, and it'll be a lot faster for me to find 2166 than trying to dig through 480 cells looking for one single cell that has the capacity of 2166 milliamp hours. All right, I hope that's helpful. I'm going to show you, I'm going to go ahead and build out a couple of these packs. I'll probably build out four, and so I can show you what they look like in a battery. And so I will be right back. All right, so I finished building out the first few. Okay. So I have finished building out the first battery. I've got four cell packs that I've put together, and you can see them here. I've divided them into cell pack A, B, C, and D, and each of those have 40 cells in them. And so you can kind of see how that comes together, and that completes one battery. And then I'll do two more after that for a total of three batteries altogether. So that will complete a single battery, and it is a 40P4S battery pack. So we have 40 in parallel and 4 in series. So it's a 40P4S battery pack. So hopefully this was helpful. If you have questions about building out battery packs, or if you have some suggestions on ways that you'd like to see it done, or ways that maybe you do it, please leave your comments in the comments below. Please subscribe and give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Thanks for watching.